of On Campus. I am your host, Haley Jacobsen. Today we are joined with Andrew Komplien, who is the director of the lottery, which will be opening this weekend in the Black Box. On Campus starts now.
California, and I competed in Management Institute at Collegiate DECA.
Did you win?
Oh, we didn't. We thought we would. We thought we had it in the bag, but
I'm just standing here. Well, I'm actually gonna order what's good here. What did you do last week?
What did I do last week? Well, I went up to the cities and did a presentation with a professor friend, the department chair, Rhonda Bonstetter, Dr. Bonstetter. Her and I went up to the cities.
Wendy here is gonna buy me a latte.
Beck and I are gonna go shopping. Let's go check it out. With the tripod, it's not that big of a deal. It's a new fashion statement we're making.
Michael, what did you do last week on campus?
Oh, well, I went to Boston and hunted down the terrace.
I'm here with Cole. Cole, what did you do last week on campus?
I made a snow fort.
I was pretty much here at work, and that's all I did.
I got my homework done. I made a snowman.
Hello, I'm here with Court, who will be coming to SMSU next year. What are you planning on doing on campus?
Well, just getting into different activities and, you know, making new friends, stuff like that.
And what's your major?
Education.
Education. Are you going to join KSSU Radio and TV Club?
I might.
Hi, I'm here with Amanda right now. Amanda? What interested you about being here at SMSU?
I don't know, I guess I came for a visit and just everybody was really friendly and I just like the environment and stuff. So.
Hello, I'm here with Jessica and she is a prospective student here at SMSU. So what made you decide to come here?
I'm playing soccer, so that pretty much made me decide kind of like this place that were looking at me.
You'd be like heaven to touch. Oh God, I want to hold you so much.
What major are you looking at here at SMSU?
Speech, communication, radio and television broadcast.
Really? Yeah, this is what you'll be doing. Hopefully you'll be able to talk better than me on camera. Yeah, so where are you originally from?
Originally from the cities, but I reside here in Marshall.
Oh. Hi, what'd you do last week on campus?
I went to class and I wrote lots of papers.
So you had a lot of fun.
Exactly, because I love school and I love SMSU.
Are you excited for school to be done soon?
I am so excited. I'm ready for summer, ready for this warm weather, ready for all the snow to get out of here.
Hello, I'm here with the beautiful and the famous and the wonderful Bobby Sufensky. Bobby, what did you do last week on campus?
I wasn't on campus. I was in class when I was.
So you were on campus. You just lied to me in an interview.
Yeah.
Stay tuned, more on campus after the break.
You can eradicate polio. You can promote peace. You can feed the hungry. You can help children do better in school. Because you can get involved with Rotary. Because Rotary believes that by working together, you can do anything. Learn more at Rotary.org.
Do you know severe joint and chest pain, fever, skin rashes, and overwhelming fatigue? Common symptoms for a challenging ailment. Lupus, a very serious, sometimes deadly immune disorder. Lupus affects millions of people, usually attacking women during their childbearing years. Symptoms are often misdiagnosed for years. Delay in treatment can cost someone you love their family or their life. The Lupus Foundation of America wants to end this by educating physicians as well as those people at risk. Please help.
So that was a look at some events that took place on campus last week.
Here's a look at some upcoming events here on the campus of SMSU.
SMSU President Ronald Wood is celebrating his retirement this Thursday, April 25th, in the Alumni Heritage Gallery. So make sure you stop by, say farewell, and grab a piece of cake.
This is Science Week. Posters can be seen all over the library plaza, so make sure you go and check them out.
Graduating seniors of the Speech Communications major will be showing off their final projects this coming Monday, April 29th, in the Library Plaza. There will also be a film screening in the Whipple Gallery from 2:30 to 5:30, so make sure you stop by and see all the cool projects.
Tommy and the High Pilots will be performing this Thursday night at 8 p.m. in the Lower Level Conference Center.
Pop-up restaurants are a new trend that is hitting SMSU. SMSU Culinary Team will be taking over a venue that is not a kitchen, staffing it with a chef and culinary team. They will be serving a three-course meal for $15. If you have any questions, make sure that you email Professor Chang for more information.
April is Sexual Assault Awareness Month, and here on the campus of SMSU, it is also the 7th Annual Fine Arts Festival. Schoolhouse Rock Live kicked off the festival the past couple weekends, and this Friday, the lottery opens in the Black Box Theater, which brings us to our guest, Mr. Andrew Komplien.
All right, we are joined with Andrew Komplien to talk a little bit about the lottery, which is opening this weekend. And Tony and I are both involved in the show, so we know a little bit about it, so the viewers today might get a little bit of an inside scoop. But can you tell us just a little bit about what the lottery is?
The lottery is an event that's held every year for the benefit of the community. And I can't really say much more than that, otherwise I'll give the majority of the plot away.
So. Right, we want to keep it a surprise for our viewers.
Well, whoever hasn't read the short story or hasn't had any previous experience with the play, I'd hate to spoil the fun for them.
Awesome. So how did you get to be the director? Because you are a student director, correct?
Correct. I approached Drama Club with a proposal to do this specific show, and they voted on it, and I was elected to do it. So that's how we choose the shows that go into the Black Box.
And this will also be your senior project?
Yes.
So what goes into not only directing a show, but also using it as your final hurrah here at SMSU?
Lots of paperwork.
Lots of paperwork.
Yeah.
So in the show, there are, I think we have 24 members in the cast, right?
Yeah.
It's a large number in a small black box, and it's not a typical setup for a show.
No, we're doing the show in a three-quarter thrust setup, so the audience sits on three sides of the performing area.
So when you were blocking this in your mind to give to your directors or your actors the blocking where they're supposed to be, how did you imagine this from not only one angle, but three?
Oh, well, I've never actually done directed in a three-quarter thrust before, so it was a lot of, well, this might work. Let's see how this plays out. And I think I got lucky more often than not.
It was all luck.
Well, not all luck. I mean, I am paying for school for something.
Right. I like during rehearsals, you were up and you were walking around and you were standing in different spots to make sure that the entire audience could see.
Yes. With that specific setup, there's certain points where you are going to have actors with their backs to, you know, a specific audience member. And the key is to try and limit that so that a person doesn't feel like they're losing the whole time. But it also gives a person more motivation to come back and see it from a different angle because it's a different show in every different seat, so.
That's really awesome. Also, in the script, there are three children that are written in, and you cast two of the college students to play two of the kid roles, but your third role, how did you go about that?
Well, that was that was a bit of a problem, and I knew it was going to be an issue from the get-go, just due to the subject matter of the show. But luckily, one of the theater professors volunteered their son to participate and act in the show, and he is of the right age. So we got, I got real lucky there that I could get someone to do it.
He's kind of got a lot of energy.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Got to keep him busy on stage.
Yeah, and it's Tony's job to make sure that he stays put. Remember that, Tony, if you're watching.
If you're watching. Also, as the student director, you are obviously directing people that you are potentially taking classes with and interacting with also on a student level. How do you come off as the head honcho in the directing or rehearsal process?
Well, I'm one of the tallest people there, so it's pretty easy.
So there you go. Listen to the big guy.
Well, it hasn't actually been really an issue. I think most of the people that have been involved in these productions have been involved in productions previously, and it's not really been an issue. People have been really willing to listen and try new things and try different things, so it's hasn't been a problem.
And just one quick thing before we are done with our interview here. It opens on Friday, and it runs until Sunday, and there are two shows on Sunday.
No. Friday night it's at 7:30.
7:30.
Saturday it's at 2:00 in the afternoon and 7:30 p.m.
Okay.
And then Sunday it's at 2:00.
Okay. So four showings, and it is $4 a ticket for students and $6, or is it just four flat?
We've got four flat across the board.
That's awesome. All right. Well, stay tuned. We'll be back with a little bit more on campus right after the break.
When I was first diagnosed with HIV, Cookie and I decided to fight this disease. Now we're here to urge you to stand with us in the fight against HIV.
In the U.S., about half of the new HIV cases have occurred among African Americans.
Get informed, get tested. Early detection can save your life. If you test positive, seek treatment from a doctor.
Go to WeStandWithMagic.com, get resources, and become a member today.
We all have a vision of that perfect smile. But when it comes to our smile, it's not something we can draw or wait to miraculously appear. We need an orthodontist. Dental specialists with 2 to 3 years of specialized education beyond dental school. Your child might be the next Picasso. So trust that brilliant smile to the right hands. Seeing an orthodontist no later than age 7 can help achieve a healthy, beautiful smile. For more information, visit braces.org.
Hello and welcome back. Be sure that you go check out the lottery this weekend. And we will be back with another episode of On Campus next week, but we'll leave you with a music video, Single Ladies, by our very own Jenna Duddleston.
See it on our faces. Our producer Kim forced us to be here against our will.
I like to think that we're dedicated.
Yeah. See, we still got our hairdo from the lottery rehearsal. It's kind of 50s.